Good morning, all, and welcome to the funeral service of our dearly departed father, Senator Onyeabo Obi Osoji Nnewi Chukwunedum. We did agree that we were going to start by 11 a.m., and we have already a lot of people hooking up online to participate in this funeral service. We understand the times we're in, and we know that because of the prevailing situation with COVID-19 and all, we cannot have a full crowd join us for this event, even though by virtue of the status of our dearly departed father, the whole country, and indeed even from beyond, would have loved to be here to pay him their final respects. The clergy are present. The Bechtel Orchestra are also ready. And the lying in state has been completed. And now the undertakers are about to wheel out our dearly departed father. And in the next 5 minutes, we will be starting the funeral service in earnest. So we request that if there are still family members who are indoors, they should please come outside and take their seat so that we can begin in earnest. It is the funeral service of a great icon, a statesman, a man of distinguished pedigree, and a patriot, Senator Onyeabo Chukwunedum Obi Osoji Nnewi. In another 5 minutes, the funeral service will commence in earnest. Thank you.
Transport.
Vegetal Orchestra, thank you, thank you.
Page 12. Heavenly Father, you have not made us for darkness and death, but for life with you forever. Without you, we have nothing to hope for. With you, we have nothing to fear. Speak to us now. Your word of eternal life. Lift us from anxiety and guilt to the light and peace of your presence, and set the glory of your love before us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Almighty God, you love everything you have made and judge us with infinite mercy and justice. We rejoice in your promises of pardon, joy and peace to all those who love you. In your mercy, turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life, and the sorrow of parting into the joy of heaven through our Savior Jesus Christ, who died, who rose again, and lives forevermore. Amen. God our Father, with faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the body of our beloved brother Onyabo for burial service. Lord Jesus Christ, you are living an imperishable word, bring us to new birth. You are eternal promises to us and to Onyabo are proclaimed in the Bible. In the name of God the Father, in the name of God the Son, and in the name of God, the Holy Spirit. Amen.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. Everyone who lives and believes in me will never die.
Amen.
She said she won't worry again.
By raising Christ, your Son, you destroy the power of death and open for us the way of eternal life. We pray with confidence, O giver of life, that you continue to shine your perpetual light on Onyabo, that he may remain in the fullness of life along with the saints through Jesus Christ our Lord. Father, grant us the assurance of your presence and grace by the Spirit you have given us through Jesus Christ our Lord. Hymn on page 13. How great thou art.
Oh,
You can sit down, soul performance.
Behold, I tell you a mystery. We shall not all sleep, but we shall all be changed in a moment, in a twinkling of an eye, at the last trumpet. Shall sound, and the dead shall be raised, and the dead shall be raised incorruptible. The trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised, be raised incorruptible, be raised incorruptible, and he shall be changed, and he shall be changed. The trumpet shall sound, the trumpet shall sound, and the dead shall be raised, be raised incorruptible, be raised incorruptible. And he shall be changed, and he shall be changed, and he shall be changed, he shall be changed, and he shall be changed. And he shall be changed, he shall be changed, and he shall be changed. He shall be changed.
last respect to Senator Onyango and to give thanks for his life, to commend him to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, to commit his body to be buried and to comfort one another. Now he is no longer with us. Grant that all who are here to celebrate the life of Onyango, especially his wife and children and all that have gathered from different places, that we shall have the assurance of your fatherly protection and love. Amen. Comfort my people, comfort my people. Bye.
Tochi Oji to take the next Bible verse. Tochi Oji, please.
And now, dear brothers and sisters, we want you to know what will happen to the people, to the believers who have died, so you will not grieve like the people who have no hope. For since believe that Jesus died and was raised again, raised to life again, we also believe that when Jesus returns, God will bring back with him the believers who have also, who have died.
Bow down your heads in prayer. page 15. God of all consolation, your son Jesus Christ was moved to tears at the grave of Lazarus, his friend. Look with compassion on your children in their loss. Give to troubled hearts the light of hope. Let your Holy Spirit remind us continually concerning our inheritance, which is your heavenly kingdom, that the cares of this world may not overpower us and make us to lose our place in your kingdom. Make us to abide in faith in your Son Jesus Christ, who is the resurrection and life for both the living and the dead, through Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Handel Messiah.
Shelter of the Most High will find rest in the shadow of the Almighty. This I declare about the Lord. He alone is my refuge, my place of safety. He is my God, and I trust him. For he will rescue you from every trap and protect you from deadly disease. He will cover you with his feathers. He will shelter you with his wings. His faithful promises are your armor and protection. Do not be afraid of the terrors of the night, nor the arrow that flies in the day. Do not dread the disease that stalks in darkness, nor the disaster that strikes at midday. Though 1,000 shall fall at your side, though 10,000 are dying around you, these evils will not touch you. Just open your eyes and see how the wicked are punished. If you make the Lord your refuge, if you make the Most High your shelter, no evil will conquer you. No plague will come near your home, for he will order his angels to protect you wherever you go. They will hold you up with their hands, so you won't even hurt your foot on a stone. You will trample upon lions and cobras. You will crush fierce lions and serpents under your feet. The Lord says, I will rescue those who love me. I will protect those who trust in my name. When they call on me, I will answer. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue and honor them. I will reward them with a long life and give them my salvation. This is the word of the Lord.
Bow down your heads in prayer. Page 14. We have come here today. God of mercy, page 16, please. God of mercy, we acknowledge that we are all sinners. We turn from the wrong that we have thought and said and done, and are mindful of all that we have failed to do for the sake of Jesus, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and help us to live each day in the light of Christ our Lord, and bring us to the eternal joy for his kingdom, where dust and ashes have no dominion. Amen. Page 16. Jesus, my beloved Redeemer. Choir.
2 Corinthians 12:8-10. 3 times I pleaded with the Lord to relieve me of this. But he answered me, my grace is always more than enough for you. And my power finds its full expression through your weakness. So I will celebrate my weaknesses. For when I'm weak, I sense more deeply the mighty power of Christ living in me. So I'm not defeated by my weakness, but delighted. For when I feel my weakness and endure mistreatment, when I'm surrounded with troubles on every side, and face persecution because of my love for Christ, I am made yet stronger. For my weakness becomes a portal to God's power. This is the word of the Lord.
This reading is from Ephesians 3, verses 20 to 21. Now to him who is able to do immeasurably more than all we ask or imagine, according to his power that is at work within us, to him be glory in the church and in Christ Jesus throughout all generations, forever and ever. Amen. This is the word of the Lord.
Time to say goodbye.
Thank you. Father, we thank you for this time to hear you speak to us. Mighty God, we are here, apostles and other disciples. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And at the end of it, Satan said, look, we have to eliminate this man Jesus on this planet. He planted his strategy and executed Jesus Christ on the cross. But not knowing that it was his what? Undoing. Jesus died. He slept. He went to the grave. Now he preached the gospel to people on earth. He went into grave, to hell. Began to preach the gospel to those people who died before he came. At the day of the resurrection, the Bible recorded that after they come and said, look, let's vomit this man out. Then Jesus Christ rose from the grave. Death could not hold him. For death could not hold him captive, even in the grave Jesus is Lord. Jesus remained the Lord, he liberated, he made the empty, and released all the world held captive. That was why the scripture, the day he rose. The people that knew their own that died over time, they saw them moving on the planet, but they could not be, you know, joining their family in the land. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So, at the end of it, Jesus went to the cross. No, after the death, he went to the grave, then from there, he ascended into heaven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Now, we say that Jesus Christ is, now he conquered Satan. Satan conquered Adam and Eve. Brought sin into the world. Don't allow Satan to conquer you. So Jesus Christ came, conquered Satan. And that's why we call Jesus more than a conqueror. More than what? A conqueror. Jesus is more than a conqueror. And anyone that comes to him is more than a conqueror. Now, if you take Jesus Christ into your life, there's a simple thing you do. Remember I said that God is a spirit. And they that worship him must worship him in spirit and truth. You are a spirit. Now, this is our decision. Do you want to make Jesus Christ your Lord and Savior? It's the hour now. If you've not done it before, it's the time for you to choose your destination. Whether your destination will be with Christ in heaven or with Satan in hell. Praise the Lord. And now, time will fail me if I would have told you a story. Now, let me just say briefly. One man, you know, was in a trance. He first of all went to hell. There was a lot of enjoyment. People were enjoying themselves. Then he went to heaven. He saw people only praying and worshiping God. I said, look. Then he came back. He said, now make your choice. Where would you like to go, heaven or hell? The man made his own choice, hell. Now, he went to hell. He saw all those enjoyment. What? Gone. It's now a place of torment. Now he cried and told Satan, why? What happened? He said, look, the time you came, I was making converts. I was making my converts so that I would not be in hell alone. And then he rushed, God, take me. So you've made your choice. Make your choice now while you're here. Shall we pray? Ebiakoro Jesus di God asawo no bara maturo uweke de ochahane kazu asawo no bara maturo asawo no bara no bara bena tobi o wegi de oj to Jesus. Hey, hallelujah. All to Jesus I surrender, all to him I will never love and trust him in his presence. I surrender. Begin to surrender to the Lord now. As individual, begin to surrender to the Lord Jesus. I surrender all to be my blessed Savior. I surrender. That's surrendering all. We're in the prayer. If you've not made decision in your life, Saul had an encounter on his way to Damascus. He met Jesus. He was persecuting the followers. He said, Lord, who are you? I said, I am Jesus who you are persecuting. So he had an encounter with the Lord. Will you have an encounter with the Lord Jesus Christ this morning? Will you have an encounter with the Lord Jesus Christ? He said, come. Come. Come unto me, all you that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you what? Rest. Since 1971 that I gave my life to the Lord Jesus Christ, he has never failed me. I saw his hand in my life. So equally too. Don't say because of wealth. Now if you leave Jesus Christ, you will not make the wealth. No, God will give you wealth. He will give you prosperity. You have good success, not bad success. You have good success, not the people that God was your ego. And then, no. Rituals, no. Surrender to the Lord Jesus Christ. And he will give you good success. Now tell Jesus, I'm a sinner. It's an individual decision. I'm a sinner. Forgive me all my sins. Wash me with the blood of Jesus Christ. Jesus, come into my life. Be my Lord and Savior. And give me the grace to live a righteous life. And to be in right standing from today onwards. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Thank you, mighty God, for your word. In Jesus' mighty name we pray.
Solo. As we sing Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. Then you start coming before the altar for prayer, family prayer. Choir. Choir.
Jehovah, wa goran wa puta. ya menu kamara omume ya nile le titindi nile tichiche tutanuna emewo ahaya denu mekanuna epe ahaya denu. I'm going to conclude it with this scripture for the family. Remember whose you are. Jesus is your strength. Holy Spirit is your guide. You are washed in the blood of Jesus Christ. Don't forget it. We are more than conquerors through Christ. St. Paul told us in Romans 8, what shall we then say these things? If God be for us, who can go against us? He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? Is it God that justifieth? Who is he that condemneth? Is it Christ that died, yet rather that is risen again, who is even at the right hand of, or who also maketh intercession for us? Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or distress or persecution or famine or nakedness or peril or sword? Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through Christ that loved us. For we are persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be ever able to separate us from the love of Jesus Christ our Lord. In Jesus' name.
Thank you very much. Can we take our seats, please? Thank you. Would like to invite Chief Dan Olasi to please step forward, and we respectfully invite Chief Dan Olasi to step forward and address the congregation, please. The Chief Dan Olasi is the Chairman, Newi Royal Cabinet. Chief Olasi.
I found it very extremely difficult not to say a few words this morning. In the past 1 week, I've received so much of abusive language from the rank and file of the People's Democratic Party. By magic, and I accepted we're burying him by magic. But I promise you, when things quieten down, I will sponsor a major Thanksgiving service for Onyango in this town or anywhere you people want it. You know, when the Reverend was saying something, you know, genetic profiling is so important in whatever you are or you do in your life. Not just that Nani Ebo, direct daughter of Ezo Bayamba, Igori is the first. And his father was the foremost Igbo leader at the time of crisis, Chief Zesi Obi. And I had a little idea, because when he was the President General of Igbo State Union, my father was the President of Igbo State Union in the North, and last chairman of ACNC before the Civil War started. So each time a telephone call comes, I answer it. It's either ZC is calling, giving instruction, or M.I. Obara is calling, giving instruction. And he married a woman, the daughter of Chief Ellen Obioha. How can you see this combination of factors? And without being responsible. So I address you as children. Your father was exemplary in knowledge, in erudition, in performance, in anything he touched. But unfortunate for me, because cabinet, it's always opposite me. There are many brilliant people in the cabinet. But the time you deliver, you will know that you haven't said anything. And when Onyango opens his mouth, you weep. How blessed the knowledge you have, if anything at all. All that is gone, but it's gone to the Lord Almighty, and we thank him for a good life. So even Nayono, you should be proud. He died well.
On the 28th of December was the last time I saw him. He was sitting next to Her Excellency. And my body. Now I see somebody in Afro, but he comes quite early. And I applaud to Ifa Igeme for the day. Somebody sitting in the Queen God Donna. So 8 days, I'm saying, what's Oji? It's not you. Osmoko, it's not me. And I think it was that was the first time he told me he was going. If only a book was in no more project, I didn't Makonye Newi will governor, Melo Zopania. And I said, I will not forget. And I promise him, I will not forget. I will do everything heavenly possible. If it is possible, if it's approval of God, to make sure that his wish is delivered. I thank you all for coming. God bless you.
Thank you very much, sir. In the same vein, may we also have Mr. Chidi Moma for his comments, please.
I didn't plan to speak, but I am here and I speak on behalf of, first and foremost, my mother, Aruna, a woman who loved her brother dearly. I think all of you who were on the night of tributes yesterday saw the pain in her eyes and in her voice when she spoke about my uncle Onyeabo. I also speak on behalf of my father, Chief Christian Moma Nagoyin Newi, a man who also loved his brother-in-law, and for whom, in fact, his brother-in-law was a great rival for his wife's love. It was often tough between who she loved more. I also have, Uncle Onyeabo brought me up. Let's be very clear about this. In the law, I was a student at his feet. He taught me everything I knew about attention to detail, about the way to practice, about the way to do things right. I know that a vote of thanks will be given, but I want to take this occasion on behalf of myself, my siblings, my parents, and everybody who loved Uncle Onyeabo to give a personal vote of thanks to Onyeabo. You are a great man. Thank you.
Thank you, Chidi. And to speak on behalf of the family and give directions for the procession to the grave, let me invite Mr. Obiora Obi.
Thank you very much. I would like to say, my father gave a lot to Newi, to Anambra, to the Igbo Nation, and to Nigeria. But I must also say, Newi has given a lot to our family. Newi has given a lot to our family. They've recognized us. They've recognized the efforts that the Obis have to what the support the Obis have to offer in the fight for the cause of Newi. My grandfather, Senator Z.C. Obi, was chairman of Newi Royal Council. My father, Senator Onyeabo Obi, was chairman of BOTCON, Board of Titled Chiefs of Newi. Igwe, Daolu no, Daolu. Bigo, I would like to invite my mother, my sisters, our spouses, my father's brothers and sisters to come to the grave so we can finally lay him to rest. Please, may everybody remain seated apart from those people so we can finally lay him to rest. Due to the fact that the space is very small, and a lot of people are all over the world are watching, so we need to let everybody who couldn't physically attend also be part of today. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Dead march in song. Choir, please, may we be on our feet.
Igwe will lead
Dead
us.
Dead march in Thank song. You. May we be on our feet.
Thank you. nation. Our Father in heaven, by your great might, you have given us new life in Christ Jesus. We commend Onye Apo unto God's loving care and mercy, and the faith we have in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord, who suffered and died and rose again to deliver us, who lives and reigns with God and the Holy Spirit in glory forever and ever. Amen. Lord, show your mercy to all who have joined here from far and near to celebrate the life of your loyal Son and servant, Onye Apo. Please give all travelers journey mercies that they may rejoin their loved ones safely. Bless them and lead them. Fight for them. Protect them from all the dangers of the journey. Give them progress in all their undertakings so that they may always enjoy your mercy and praise. You and your goodness, and they may be counted among the faithful and in the company of the holy ones through our Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.
Page 24, Safe in the Arms of Jesus. Now straight to the grave, yeah, outside. Fire. Clear.
Rest of us should please be comfortably seated. Thank you.
Consecrate the grave.
Our Heavenly Father, bless this grave as the resting place of the body of your loyal Son and servant, Prince Onye Apo, the doomed, whom you have welcomed to his eternal rest in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Now, brothers and sisters, I want to remind you of the gospel I preached to you, which you received and on which you have taken your stand. By this gospel, you are saved. If you hold firm to the word I preached to you, otherwise you have believed in vain. But if it is preached that Christ has been raised from the dead, how can some of you say that there is no resurrection of the dead? If there is no resurrection of the dead, then not even Christ has been raised. And if Christ has not been raised, our preaching is useless, and so is your faith. More than that, we are then found to be false witnesses about God, for we have testified about God that he raised Christ from the dead. But he did not raise him if, in fact, the dead are not raised. For if the dead are not raised, then Christ has not been raised either. And if Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile. You are still in your sins. Then those who have fallen asleep in Christ are lost. If only for this life we have hope in Christ, we are of all people most to be pitied. Now, if there is no resurrection, what will those do who are baptized for the dead? If the dead are not raised at all, why are people baptized for them? Where, O dead, is your victory? Where, O dead, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, he gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain.
All together, page 21, let us say that prayer. Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may live as those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen. We have entrusted our brother Onyeabo to God's mercy, and we now commit his body to the ground.
Thank you.
Dust to dust.
ensure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ, who will transform our frail bodies, that they may be conformed to his glorious body, who died, was buried, and rose again for us. To him be glory forever.
Amen. Nunc Dimittis, page 23. Nunc Dimittis.
Fire.
Nunc Dimittis.
Thank you. For our audience who are on Zoom, YouTube, and all our online channels, thank you very much for being with us from yesterday, even up until today. Senator Onyango Chukwune Edumu Obi has been committed to Mother Earth. His children and relatives are performing the Dust to Dust rites. The clergy have officially conveyed his soul to the Kingdom of God. We thank in the most special way Igwe Oriz Igwe Nnewi, who has come to bid farewell to a very illustrious son of Nnewi and the chairman of the body of tribal chiefs of Nnewi, the confidant of the family of the trial and the righteous advice. Igwe Oriz Igwe Oriz, thank you very much for being with us. To Chief Dan Olasi, all the other members of the Igwe cabinet, everyone who could not be with us physically because of the COVID-19 restrictions, all friends of the children, all friends of the family, well wishers who would have loved to be with us, who unfortunately are not able to make it. We thank you, we understand, and we accept your solidarity and your friendship, and we thank you for logging on online to be with us. All friends, all family members, all well-wishers who did make it here, we thank you, and collectively we say, may the soul of our Father find rest in the bosom of our Lord. We also thank in a special way Her Excellency Dame Virgie Etiaba, former governor of Anambra State, who has come to be with us here today.
From here, what fate is drawing near? Touch my heart and guide my lips in prayer. Through the grace of God alone,
on that note of gratitude, would like to invite Reverend Dr. Daisy Obi to formally close the service for us. Reverend Dr. Obi.
Father, we thank you in Jesus' name by the power of the Holy Spirit. May God give his comfort and his peace, his light, and his joy in this world and the next, and the blessing of God, the Father Almighty, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst us and remain with us always in Jesus' name. Thank you. Go in peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you very much, Reverend Dr. Daisy Obi. Thank you to all who have come. Thank you to our Zoom audience. Thank you to our online audience. Thank you very much, everyone.
Father, you are worthy. Savior, Father, you are worthy, Savior, thou art worthy, thou alone art worthy to be praised, thou alone art worthy to be praised, thou alone art worthy to be praised, thou alone art worthy to be praised.
Walk, you made
the blind to see. La baketa la daba. Jesus. Join us and give him praise. Now alone made a blind to see. Now alone made a lame to walk. Now alone made a deaf man to hear. Now alone I'm ready to be praised. The Lion of the tribe of Judah. Situation that we alone not wanting to be praised. Hey, hey, hey. Onye di kajuba. Why not come and celebrate Jesus? Who is like unto him? He's the only one that put a smile on your face. When people think you cannot smile again. Oh, 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 oh.
Ah, equipment.
Check. Hello. Hello. T. Hello. T. T.
Cabinet.
Thank you very much. Here's your microphone.
Father, you are the king that can never fail. Bye.